How to handle my forceful letdown. Hi, Mommy. In this video, I'm going to give you some tips to help baby handle your forceful letdown, how to control it, and how to maintain that control long term. Now, if you haven't already, I'd like you to go and watch my video on how to know if I have a forceful letdown. I'll link it right here. But if you've already watched that, let's go. Hi, Mommy. My name is Mary Cahill, and I'm a certified lactation counselor. I use correct and easy to understand information to help mommies like you to be confident and successful in their breastfeeding journey. In the first few weeks, most moms have their milk come out forcefully. If you're still having an issue after about 4 to 6 weeks, then you may have the condition forceful letdown and oversupply. They go together. If you have one, you'll have the other. It may not seem like it if you can't pump out a large amount, but when baby's latched at the breast, a large amount goes into baby. So in those first few weeks, you're establishing your milk supply. So you don't want to do anything to reduce or slow down your milk supply. In those first few weeks, we're just going to help baby to be able to handle the forceful letdown. After about 6 weeks, there's some things you can do to help to control it. And then you can do both, controlling it and help baby to be able to handle it. But right in the beginning, we're just going to help baby to be able to not choke on your milk. So when you're normally nursing baby in kind of a cross cradle or cradle hold, baby chokes pretty easily when you have a letdown. If you'll angle baby just a little bit, that may help a lot of babies so that they don't have choking problems when you have your letdown. You can also lay back to nurse baby. Prop up some pillows behind you so it's like you're laying back watching a movie. The gravity will help a little bit so baby won't choke quite so much. Also, you can take baby off the breast when you see that you're having a letdown. Some moms feel their letdown, and even if you don't, that's totally fine. Nothing wrong with it if you don't feel your letdown. You may have to watch, and when you see baby start to choke or guzzle your milk, that's when you can take baby off. Have a towel and let your milk just spray into a towel, or you can have a container and let the milk spray into a container if your milk sprays. Once you get through that letdown, then you can latch baby again. Now, moms usually have several letdowns in a nursing session. If your next letdown is choking baby again, then you'll take baby off again. You can also help baby by stopping several times and burping baby. That'll slow baby up, and also baby gets extra air in their tummy when they're gulping, so that will help baby to not get a tummy ache. You can also be sure that baby has a good latch. I have a video on how to get a good latch, and I'll link that above. Quite often, when mom has a forceful letdown, baby will slip out to the nipple, and it will get even more air in baby's tummy. Baby may bite down on mom's nipple to control the flow, and then baby may even choke even more. So you'll want to check out that video too. Most mom's milk regulates at around 8 weeks, but when you have a forceful letdown, it may be 3 months or even later before you see your milk supply regulate. What I mean by regulate is that when baby was born, there was a release of hormones telling your body to make more milk. And so your body was able to make even more milk than baby needed. At around that time, 8 weeks or later, and your milk supply regulates, it goes down to just what baby needs. But you may not see that for a long time if you have a forceful letdown and oversupply. Some moms with a forceful letdown decide to be an exclusive pumper, and that can work for some moms, but it can still be a problem if you're pumping out more milk than baby needs. Having this condition is a two-part problem. So the first part is how fast the milk goes into baby. But the second part is the imbalance between your foremilk and hind milk. So foremilk has slightly less fat in it, and hind milk has a little bit more fat in it, which normally you don't need to worry about. Baby needs that foremilk and hind milk. But if you're pumping out a large amount, baby can never eat enough to get down to that fattier milk. They may try to eat a lot more often and seem really hungry, but they can never get down to enough fat. And that's why we see a lot of these babies, when mom has this condition, we'll see a baby often be underweight or at least a low weight gainer. If you are an exclusive pumper or you pump a lot, you just don't want to remove that extra amount of milk. Some moms say, well, I'll just use the Haka because that won't be like pumping. But a Haka, called a silicone pump, when that goes on, it's like a pump because it will suction to your breast. And see how that's indented in there? There's an air suction and gives some pulling action. So that is like a pump. So a Haka is not the best for catching your milk because it's still going to increase your milk supply. I really like collection cups. And these you just wear inside your bra, especially when you're nursing on one side and you have it on the other. It will catch the leaks and drips. If you want to have a little bit of an emergency supply or you're feeling really engorged and you want to remove a little bit of milk, that really helps to be able to collect that. And these are sanitizable like you would a bottle, and there's an opening at the top and you can just pour it into a collection container. But that catches leaks instead of drawing the milk out. The best way for a mom with a forceful letdown and oversupply to control it is to block feed. And block feed means that you're going to do a block of time on one breast and then a block on the other. So anytime baby needs to eat for the next 3 hour block, you're only going to nurse baby on this side. And then the next block of time, baby will only nurse on the other side. Now the side that baby doesn't nurse on may get a little bit uncomfortable and a little bit engorged, and you don't want to let that happen. So you may need to pump just a little bit. You don't want to overpump, but a little bit will help. Just enough to become comfortable. Now you'll want to use an electric or manual pump, or even your Haka, but you don't want to do hand expressing because that will stimulate more milk and it won't be helping to reduce that supply. Also, you can apply cold compresses. I really like gel packs. You can put them right in your bra. They come with nice covers and I'll put a link to those. But if you don't have them, you could put a cold washcloth in a baggie and put that in your bra. So engorgement is inflammation. So the cold will help to reduce the inflammation. So you want to use that anytime after you pump or nurse in the time when you're trying to reduce that supply. Moms with a forceful letdown get engorged more often and stay engorged a longer period of time, like for months. So you want to do what you can to reduce that. Also, ibuprofen helps to reduce it also. So if you're one that ibuprofen is fine for you to take, then you can take it because it's safe for baby while breastfeeding. When mom has a forceful letdown and oversupply, there's some things she may need to do to maintain control. If baby's not feeling well or been teething and they want to be at the breast more often, that can increase supply. So you may need to go back to longer block feeding time and apply those cold compresses and maybe ibuprofen again. If you've been pumping a lot and then you decide to go back to maybe baby's latching more, again, you'll need to watch and be able to maintain that control. Any extra stimulation will increase your supply. So if you wore a loose shirt and no bra and your shirt rubbed up against your nipples, that's extra stimulation. So you want to be cautious with that. In the shower, if you let the shower water run directly on your breast, that's extra stimulation. So you need to just keep that under control the best you can. Having a forceful letdown and oversupply can be just as stressful as having a low milk supply. I hope that some of these tips that I've given you today will help you to get your supply under control. Let me know in the comments, what things have you been doing to help to get your supply under control and how is that working for you? I have a group called the Inner Circle. If you become a member, then you can be in a private Facebook group where I answer questions and other moms interact and support each other. I'll put a link below if you want to check that out. I hope this has been super helpful for you today, Mommy. Be sure to like and subscribe to my channel so you don't miss any future videos, and give me a thumbs up. Thanks a lot, Mommy. You got this.